Hi, Izzy. There
Going
we go. How's it going?
pretty good. How
Good.
about
I'm so glad to
you?
hear that. I'm having a good week. All right. So tell me about our last session. What were some of the things that stuck with you that you thought, oh, this was going really well? Some things that maybe were things that you wanted to hold on to and keep using, maybe like, tools you tucked in your tool belt to pull out later. And what were maybe some things that you thought, oh, it'd be good if I kept working on this? And do you have any ideas for what you'd like us to focus on in this session?
Well, definitely what I've taken away from last time was finding like characters who I can relate to, and
Yeah.
since we've already did my side of like wanting to have someone special in my life with the romantic French characters,
Yeah.
maybe we can do another side of me that I can be related to.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, I love that. So, what were you thinking?
Oh man, well, there's still many characters too. Like, well, definitely like one of my traits in my personality, definitely like making people smile.
Okay. Well, that's good, making people smile. Can you think of any characters that you think you feel like would be that kind of a character?
Well, definitely, people making him people smile. Well, definitely. Or just people with like characters with like positive attitude.
Okay, characters that have positive attitudes. I love it. So what's a show that you have watched recently?
Well, there's a couple of shows I've been watching recently, like a
Okay.
couple of few cartoons.
Okay.
But there's so many of them who I can relate to.
Yeah. What about SpongeBob? I feel like that's
Yes,
one
SpongeBob.
that most people know, and that's a character who's very enthusiastic, optimistic, always ready to help.
Sounds
He's got
like
that
me.
like can-do attitude, big smile, right?
Yes, the SpongeBob is
Helpful.
definitely one of them.
Yeah, so I think SpongeBob might be a good character to work on today.
And then, of course, Alistair from Hazbin Hotel with that Cheshire cat-like grin of his.
I love that. Okay, Alistair. Any others that you can think of?
Oh, definitely Bugs Bunny. He's always like is making people smile with all of his tricks up his sleeve.
I love it. Yeah, so we've got a few good ideas here. All right, so why don't we look at let's look at SpongeBob first. So tell me a little bit about SpongeBob.
Well, definitely very very happy, very funny, lots of energy.
Absolutely.
And is always ready for either work or play
Yeah.
or just ready for a fun adventure.
Okay, absolutely. So let's take a look at the script I just put into the chat here. Let's first have you just read through it in your regular voice, and then we'll go from there.
All right. Oh boy, another beautiful day in Bikini Bottom. You know, there's nothing quite like waking up, flipping on my crusty crab hats and heading to work. I mean, who else gets to make delicious mouth-watering Krabby Patties all day? Not everybody's lucky enough to have a job where they can spread joy one burger at a time. And sure, maybe Squidward doesn't always love my singing or my, well, enthusiasm. But hey, that's okay. I've got enough happiness for both of us.
Yes, good. All right. So, what do you think is happening here?
Definitely another bright and beautiful day, maybe even a Monday, since everybody in the world probably like hates Mondays.
Okay.
And maybe like talking as he's like getting ready, like getting dressed. Definitely like probably like talking to Gary the snail.
Yeah, okay, that definitely could be happening here. So how does he feel about Gary?
Definitely be like, almost like a good pal, like a trusty sidekick, as much as well as Patrick is. And he's like, this is almost like how I am with my pet, my cat Delilah, to be exact.
Okay, so what do you think happened right before this monologue started?
Probably just got woken up by that loud alarm clock that he has,
Okay,
and
yeah.
probably looked up at the window and like jump up to my feet and be like, "Oh boy, a brand new day."
Yeah. Nice. Good. So then, what would you say then, is your goal here? What do you want here? What are you trying to get?
Probably to like tell the like show the audience like the side of like enthusiasm, positivity, and optimism.
Yeah.
And something that they can carry on whenever they think like tomorrow is gonna be awful. Probably just like remember me and like what I've said in this like episode here.
Yeah.
Something they can take away from.
Okay, good. All right. So tell me a little bit more about the character's voice now. What do we want to do with their voice?
Oh boy, this is gonna be awesome. So definitely like with the voice, definitely be like what Tom Kenny described, like almost like his like with well with the laugh, definitely with a dolphin like laugh, and definitely like a bit of squeaky in there, or kind of like a squeaky kind of sponge he is,
Yeah.
and very like energetic, full of happiness and sunshine.
Nice. Good. Yeah. So would you say, so you know what? With all those insights, let's go ahead and we're gonna dive in, and I want you to just run with it.
All right. Gonna channel my inner Tom Kenny.
I love it. Let's do it.
Oh boy, a beautiful day in Bikini Bottom. You know, there's nothing quite like waking up, flipping on my crusty crab hat, and heading out to work. I mean, who else gets to make delicious mouth-watering Krabby Patties all day? Not everyone's lucky enough to have a job where they can spread joy one burger at a time. And sure, maybe Squidward doesn't always love my singing or, my enthusiasm, but hey, that's okay. I've got enough happiness for both of us.
Nice. Good. All
You
right.
know, I
So,
had to add in the laugh, even though my.
yes. Hey,
Even
that's
though,
all right. I love it. I think that's a really creative way to bring the character to life. All right.
yes,
So, would you say this character has more of a high-pitched voice or a low-pitched voice?
definitely a higher,
And would you say they talk faster or slower?
maybe like a little faster.
Would you say that they have any particular speech patterns, like dialects, accents, a lisp, any, nasality, any qualities to their voice?
Maybe a little bit of nasality
Yeah.
goes with.
Yep. SpongeBob does have a little bit of nasality.
Since I've noticed that the character has a little bit of a pointy nose to him.
Yeah, and he does talk with nasality. So yeah, so we're gonna have a little bit more of that this time. Anything else that you feel like we'd want to change? I think you definitely are trying to, maybe you're trying to cheer up a friend who's like kind of down. Could we try that?
Sure. All right. Here you go. Oh boy, another beautiful day in Bikini Bottom. You know, nothing's quite not there's nothing in quite like waking up, flipping on my crusty crab hat, and heading out to work. I mean, who else gets to make delicious mouth-watering Krabby Patties all day? I mean, Not everyone's lucky enough to have a job where they can spread joy one burger at a time. And sure, maybe Squidward doesn't always love my singing or, well, enthusiasm. But, that's okay. I've got enough happiness to last both of us.
Very good. Awesome. All right. So then, how did you like that take? How did you feel about it?
Definitely feel like definitely very relatable.
Yeah.
And yeah, overall I liked it.
Good. I'm so glad. All right. Excellent. So then, let's try another character now. So this one is Bugs Bunny.
All right.
Okay, so when you look at this here, what do you think is going on? Who do you think he's talking to? What do you think is happening here?
Well, as I read it, and what's up, Doc? I gotta say, if there's one thing I love, it's making people happy. Some folks like to be all serious, but not me. Nah. All right. Life's too short to go around looking to swallow a looking. Life's too short to go around looking like you swallowed a lemon. I mean, and have you ever noticed just as how just a little smile can turn someone's day around? It's like magic, or maybe it's just good old charm. Who knows? Well, definitely be like here. Maybe like I've like probably like during one day, I'm getting all the attention in the world, but then I see probably like who we worked on a couple weeks months ago, like Daffy probably like sitting on the cor like sitting at a table all alone, probably like looking at me like all with all jealousy and anger, or like probably saying to himself like it's not fair, how come he gets all the attention? But then as soon as like the crowd leaves to probably go like to some special venue, I like head over to Daffy and like sit across from him and kind of like almost giving him like a piece of advice
Yeah.
so that he can be just as beloved as I am.
Okay, yeah. So
But
then, yeah. So tell me a little bit more about this character's voice now.
well, definitely what I remember from the original voice actor, I forgot his name. Mel Blanks, that's it. It's like, well, talk about this character's voice. He does also has a bit of a high voice, but except with SpongeBob, Bugs here has a mix of a Brooklyn and Bronx accent. Kind of like how Angel does has his Brooklyn slash Bronx accent.
Yeah. Okay. So how do you think Bugs Bunny's voice is different from yours?
Well, a little bit of the accent, of course. And maybe a little bit on the words, like how he is pronouncing his words, like with the nah. Life's too short, and with the looking like you swallowed a lemon, it's looking like you swallowed a lemon. And so kind of like a little play on words, like rearrange letters here and there.
Okay, so good. Really good insights. Let's try it again.
All right. Nah, what's up, Doc? I gotta say, if there's one thing I love, it's making people laugh. I mean, folks like to be all serious, but not me. Nah, life's too short to go around and looking like you swallowed a lemon. I mean, have you ever noticed how just one little smile can turn someone's life around? It's like magic. Or maybe just good old charm, you know? Who knows?
All right. Good. I thought that was better. What did you like better about it?
I definitely liked it a lot better.
Yeah. Good. All right. How did you like it better? What was better about it for you?
Definitely like channeling the character. And since, kind of like, oh my gosh, what's the word here? Well, when I was like probably like 13, I kind of did like a Bugs Bunny voice one time, but I think with this one, I've kind of like almost made it sound like the original. So yeah, that's what I also liked about it.
Awesome. Good. So then, if you were going to change anything this time through, what would it be?
I don't think I would change anything around in this one. Well, maybe kind of like take it like soft and easy, probably because like I'm like comforting Daffy over here and like in this scene.
Yeah.
So maybe like a little bit softer,
Okay.
like kind of like
Yeah.
cheer him up and like get him out of his jealousy.
I love that idea.
All right. All right, here we go. Me, what's up, Doc? You know, I gotta say, if there's one thing I love, it's making people laugh. Some folks like to be all serious, but not me. Nah, life's too short to go around looking like you swallowed a lemon. I mean, have you ever noticed just how one little smile can turn someone's day around? It's like magic. Or maybe just good old charm. Who knows?
Nice. Good. I really like that take. It was really fun. And I agree. I felt like it's like it was more encouraging, you know, like considerate of your friend and more encouraging. What did you like about it?
Definitely. I agree with you a lot, Vandy, with that one.
Good. I'm so glad. Awesome. I thought it was a great take. So why don't we try playing with an Alistair
All
script
right.
now? All right, so this is basically like him on his radio show.
Yes. Like, good
Okay.
to be back on the air.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I need a megaphone to make me sound like I'm actually on a radio like he does on the show.
Yeah,
But for
that would
right
be really
now,
fun.
yeah, but for right now, good evening, my friend. Aren't we all just tickled pink to be here together? Now, I know, this place might be hell, but that's no reason to be glum. Life, or unlife, is much more entertaining with a smile, wouldn't you agree? So gather around. I'll let you in on a little secret I've learned over the years. The trick to making people smile isn't about being nice. It's about being entertaining.
Nice. Awesome. How'd that feel?
Definitely very feel like very energetic.
I'm so glad. Awesome. All right. So then, tell me a little bit about this character. Where are they? Who are they talking to? What just happened right before this?
Well, what happened right before this? I probably like he's just arrived in hell
Yeah.
and maybe be like, has found an old radio station that probably hasn't been used in years, but now he's like got it up and running again.
Yeah.
And like people are just tuning into the show, or rather his show.
Yeah.
And like probably like all like down and miserable. Like, who wants to be in this stupid place? Like, even in death, like it's kind of all like moody and sad, but then I'm like here to cheer everybody up since
Yeah.
that was probably what I was known for,
Right.
or when I was like when he was like alive. So yeah, that's what my take on it is.
Nice. Love it. All right. So then, what would you say this script needs?
What this script needs probably like Oh, I've got a crazy idea. How about like maybe a bit of like old radio music playing in the background?
Okay,
Kind of get the
so
swing
that
in.
we can add with editing, but what if you just sort of like imagine that in your mind, kind of put yourself in that world and then try it again and just try to really activate your imagination.
All right, I can do that.
Great.
Let's see. Here he goes. Oh, and definitely like for the script, I like come in as like a grand entrance. Let's see, like, ha. Good evening, my friends. Aren't we all just tickled pink to be here together? Now, I know, this place may be hell, but that's no reason to be glum. Unlife is much more entertaining with a smile, wouldn't you agree? So gather around. I'll let you in on a little secret I've learned over the years. The trick to making people smile isn't about being nice. It's about being entertaining.
Good. All right. So tell me a little bit more about this character's voice. How are you creating that voice? How are you using your resonators? What about the tongue shapes? Like, how are you creating this particular character voice?
Well, definitely be like going all attic. Maybe even like trying to smile with every word I say. Even with like the with the good evenings, I kind of have to smile to make it like a good evening. Make those oohs a little more longer.
Yes, good. What else?
Definitely. And same thing with the so, like the so gather around. Kind of like make them a little longer.
Yeah. Love it. Good. All right, so then, let's go ahead and we're gonna try. I'm gonna have you try. I want there to be a little more like a wow factor because you've been like missing for a long time, right? So
Yeah,
let's do
ever
it
since
like
I've
this
died in the
is your,
1930s.
right? Like everyone thinks you're dead. So let's make it like you're shocking everyone with this big reveal that you are just like popping back up and it's like, where have you been? You know, so playing with that element of that this is your first thing back.
All right, first thing back.
Yeah.
My big premiere, my comeback special.
Yes.
All right. I can do this. Where's a megaphone when you need one? Great. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, my friends. Aren't we all just tickled pink to be here together? Now, I know, this place may be hell, but that's no reason to be glum. Life, rather, afterlife is much more entertaining with a smile. You wouldn't agree, right? All right, can I try that line again? Life,
Yeah.
afterlife is much more entertaining with a smile, wouldn't you agree? So gather around. I'll let you in on a little secret I've been learning over these years. The trick to making people smile isn't about being nice. It's about being entertaining.
Nice. Good. Awesome. What do you think of that take?
A whole lot better.
Yeah, that was great. All right. So now I'm gonna have you, so is there anything else that you can think of that you feel like would make it even better? I really liked the pitch variations that you put in there.
All right. I don't think I would do anything else.
Okay, great. Awesome. So then let's try our Dora script then. I put a Dora and a Mickey Mouse in the chat.
All right.
All
Let
right.
me. Well, I don't think I'm gonna get to the I'm gonna
Oh, that's
start
okay.
off with the Mickey Mouse one,
Sure,
so
yeah. Let's try that.
I'm just gonna read it in my regular voice. Let's
Okay,
see.
let's do it.
Hiya, pals. Gosh, it's great to see ya. You know, I was just thinking, no matter what kind of day you're having, it's always going to be spread with a little happiness. Sometimes things might not go exactly how we planned. Maybe your project didn't turn out right, or maybe you lost something important. But if you stay positive and keep smiling, there's always a bright side.
Nice. Good. All right. So then, tell me a little bit about what's happening in this particular script.
Well, definitely what's going on here, maybe like a word of advice, like maybe like a cartoon was playing of mine, and like I came up before like the end credits to give like a word of advice, like advice of the day with Mickey.
Yeah.
And kind of like giving like a little advice to like the children and all that, and not only like when you wish upon a star or like have a magical day, kind of like, well, maybe like putting like the two together, but kind of like making it a little more differently.
Okay. Good. All right. So, in what ways? In what ways would it be different?
Kind of be more like uplifting, maybe.
Okay.
And definitely a lot like with Alistair, maybe like a great big smile on your face, or maybe as you're like saying this monologue.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think that's what's going on here.
Awesome. Very good. All right. So then let's go ahead and let's try it again.
Oh, but we're already out of time.
Well, let's at least try it.
All right. All right. Oh my gosh, I haven't done this voice in such a long time, but here we go. Hiya, pal. Gosh, it's great to see you. You know, I was just thinking the other day, no matter what kind of day you're having, it's always good to spread a little happiness. Sometimes things might not go exactly how we planned. Maybe your project didn't turn out right, or maybe you lost something important. But if you stay positive and keep smiling, there's always a bright side.
Good, awesome. So I think it can have a little bit of more like a whoo, hoo, hello,
Woo,
kittens.
woo,
Like a
hot
little more of
dog.
this hootie element back here. Like
All right,
hello, Minnie.
I can do that.
Hiya, pals. A
Hiya,
little more
pal.
rounded and tall, a little less smiley, a little more rounded and tall
Okay.
and hootie.
All right. Rounded. I can do that. Here goes nothing. Hiya, pal. Gosh, it's great to see ya. You know, I was just thinking the other day, no matter what kind of day you're having, it's always gonna spread. It's always good to spread a little happiness. Haha. Sometimes things might not go exactly how we planned. Maybe your project didn't turn out right, or you just lost something important. But if you stay positive and keep smiling, there's always a bright side.
Good. Awesome. All right, how'd that feel?
A lot better.
Good. I'm so glad. All right. So then, so what would you say would be a takeaway from that? Something that you can like give yourself a note to tuck away in your brain, tuck in your tool belt that you can hold on to and use this week.
Definitely something I can like hang on to the all these like dive into a little more of the voices and like
Yeah.
finding out what's going on in this in this script, like what's happening before this or what's happening during this.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think I can do practice like that.
Can I have you work on the Mickey and the Dora script this week on your own?
Yes, and I
Awesome.
just copied and pasted them.
Great. Excellent. Okay, good. And this week, what's going to be your practice goal for the week? Like, how many days are you going to try to practice? How long are your practice sessions going to be?
I don't know, 'cause I have a pretty busy schedule.
That's okay. Could we maybe try to do at least maybe like at least two times between now and when I see you again?
Yes, we can do that.
All right, great. Awesome. Okay, well, wonderful work today, Miss Izzy. Tell me, what was maybe the most fun thing about the session today?
Oh, definitely the fun session here.
Yeah.
Just living in the moment of all these characters.
Oh, I love that. Living in the moment. That's a good one. What would you say is maybe the thing you feel like you grew the most in that area?
But I grew the most. Definitely like releasing all of my energy and even like challenging my acting skills.
Yeah, nice. Good. And then what would you say is maybe the thing that you feel like you need the most work on?
Maybe the most like well, like kind of like the rounded sounds, a little more of like pronunciation in words, and
Okay,
maybe
yeah.
a hint of accents work.
Yeah, I love it. Yes, nice. So a thing that might be fun for you to do this week would be to check out the international Dialects of English Archive. It's free, it's online. I will find the website for you.
All right.
Yeah, so this is free. It's been put together by researchers, and academics, and basically it's just people speaking English from all over the world. And you can listen to probably 1,000 or more different recordings that they've made. So you can go there and you can click on like Africa, Asia, the Caribbean, Europe, North America, South America, right? So if I click Asia, then I can pick a country there. So I can say, okay, let's go to India, right? And then I have 17 different recordings of people talking with an Indian accent, right? So it's a great free resource. I'd love for you to check that out.
All right.
All right, Izzy, wonderful work this week, and I will see you in a week. All right, I'll see you Wednesday.
See you Wednesday.
Bye, Izzy.